Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Future of Learning Conversations. My name is Joe Farrell, Managing Director at KPMG Learning Services. In my opinion, we're facing the largest workforce transformation in history. It all stems from a healthcare crisis, COVID-19, an economic crisis, a social crisis, and to add fuel to the fire, a climate crisis that is escalating daily. It's quite clear to me that the appetite for upskilling has increased, and here to talk with me today is Alessandro Giacobbe, GM of Enterprise Learning at Microsoft.
Thank you, Joe. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
So, Alessandro, given the current disruptions in the marketplace, there's obviously a huge need for upskilling. One of the things we see right now is a emergence of a K-shaped recovery. The populations that are aligned to industries and organizations that are modernizing, digitizing, and upskilling are going to be well positioned to support the future workforce. Other organizations or populations like the underserved communities that don't have access to those opportunities and those services are going to be challenged. Microsoft and KPMG are looking for modern learning solutions to not only deliver to those organizations that are investing in upskilling, but also to deliver to those underserved communities so we can help those communities gain the skills they need to participate in the future workforce. What type of market conditions are you seeing out there from a Microsoft perspective?
Absolutely. In a way, you could almost say that in the midst of all these events that you mentioned, all these challenges, and the fact that technology is actually evolving and innovating at a pace that's faster than never before. You hear about metaverse all of a sudden. It's like, okay, what is this thing? What are we supposed to do with it? How does it impact my job? So it's almost like a great leveler, if you will, because the challenges that you feel as somebody who is underprivileged to a certain extent are similar to the challenges of somebody who can be an executive in a job, because you need to transform your job. You need to evolve it. You need to acquire new skills. You really need to do things differently because of all these changes that are happening around you. So it all points in the same direction, which is that the digital transformation is upon us. And to get the most out of it, whether you are just getting started and you don't have skills in the particular job that you want to have, or you're an incumbent who's been there a long time and you need to reinvent yourself in a way, you need to acquire new skills, the problem is not that different. And so we're here to try to help.
So what I'm hearing, Alessandro, is we need to design, build, and organize different to prepare the future workforce. And the reason being, from my perspective, is legacy learning models and current learning models, event-based models, are really struggling with the demand and the scale of this challenge. To me, when you look at a traditional model, it's event-based, that takes the employee out of the workplace to deliver learning and then puts them back into it, so it's disruptive there. It's not integrated into the flow of work.
And without throwing away everything that we have, because there are a lot of things that work extremely well, but in reality, things around you change all the time. And we have studies that show that actually when we poll employees, whether it is our company or other companies, and we ask them about a month after they've taken a training class, how much do you remember of that training class? The amount of information that gets lost is a lot. And so why is that? Why can't we make training such that, especially now that you are required to take it to keep up your skills, why can we make it more engaging? Why can't we make it so that it is in the flow of work? You know, something we hear a lot about. And we have Microsoft Teams, a social collaboration platform, which is where productivity happens. And collaboration is really escalated. But the formal training that's required, why can't we bring it into that flow of work, as opposed to pausing, interrupting the flow of work, the productivity flow, and have the employee go take a training class in a different environment and then hope that they remember? If it's contextualized right where they are, then the value that employees get is much higher. And this is actually demonstrated.
So, Alessandro, you're touching on some very good points there. It's kind of the attributes of the future of learning. From my perspective on what we're seeing in our Center of Excellence that does our research, is the future of learning needs to have a several attributes or pillars. Number one, it needs to be immediate or accessible to these audience.
Sure.
Number two, it needs to be personalized. The system really needs to know the individual, where they are from a skills perspective, and how can they accelerate that upskilling to competency and to mastery. Another thing, attribute about a modern learning environment that I think will really help out is the integration and intelligence behind the integration. And then obviously the content, the actual experience. Any thoughts around, you know, how Viva in the suite can deliver those attributes to the experience?
The first starting point is that learning is really changing. It's changing from becoming, in the corporate world, an activity that was an end to becoming a means to an end, where the end is productivity. And so you learn to get things done, to complete a project, to get the information that you need to be equipped with the tools that enable you to be productive. And this is really critical because there are studies now that show that when employees feel like they're getting things done, they're productive, that drives their happiness. And that happiness drives engagement, which is critical, as you know, as you teach me, having been in this business for a very, very long time. And when there is that level of engagement that's heightened, the level of happiness, that drives performance and retention, which is something every organization is trying to solve for. How do I keep valuable employees? How do I make employees productive? So when we solve for capabilities, then, and we have a system that enables to keep up with all the changes around us, then it's when we make employees and we give them what they really need to get things done and to acquire skills that can be great for the next step in their careers, regardless, again, if they are just getting started in an underprivileged area or if they are executives as a very large organization worldwide.
So it's very interesting you talk about productivity, performance, and wellness. CEOs and our leaders out there, that's front and center on their agenda and their strategic plans for next year and beyond. One of the things I would say is, you know, from our at KPMG, we did a survey, a CEO survey, and obviously the majority of CEOs are very optimistic about the growth potential. And one of the other things that's really positive is 79% of CEOs said they want their employees to be more innovative and take more risks, which is fantastic.
Incredible, huh?
Any thoughts around that in terms of leadership? We believe leadership gets it. They're putting that into their strategic plans about upskilling. They're investing in that area. And they're even given the nod to go ahead and be a little more innovative, a little more risk-taking. Yeah. Because we have to be, right?
For sure. And we have had this at Microsoft. We call it a growth mindset, which really requires a culture transformation, as we said, which is fundamental to be able to get the most out of the digital transformation and the big investment that companies are making. And you asked before about, you mentioned Viva, Microsoft Viva before. This is exactly what we tried to help organizations achieve. And we started with the realization that Microsoft Teams is a social collaboration platform used by hundreds of millions of people. And if you're using a social collaboration platform, whichever one you choose to use, you are learning from each other. So the informal learning is happening. It is actually how people learn and get things done. But at the same time, for compliance reasons, for professional development reasons, for keeping up with changes in the marketplace, as we talked about before, keeping up with technology, formal learning is super helpful. It's critical. So why not bring the two together? And that is the base behind Viva Learning, which is the learning module of the Microsoft Viva Employee Experience Platform. But this is what we're trying to do our part in terms of enabling that transformation at the culture and at the learning level that we were discussing earlier that we feel is actually critical.
Yeah, no, I love the way you describe that. I mean, it's an intuitive, efficient experience, right, for the employee, and it evolves over time. You know, in our partnership together, obviously the KPMG role is around the managed services, innovative managed mm-hmm. services. And the way we're structured, Alessandro, as you know, we have our center of excellence that develops our point of view. And very often we can deliver that to the market, but then the market yeah. comes back and says, how do I validate that's right for me? And that's where we bring our strategy and transformation in, where we co-design the future of learning for our clients. One of the things I would say when we do co-design We want to design a model that continuously evolves, right? Is that it doesn't come complacent or stale over time. So the innovation is basically part of the model, and it's built into the model going forward.
In terms of looking for the efficiency in this industry, that in many ways is very inefficient, because when people can only remember 10 to 15% of what they learn, it's like, okay, why do we have to accept 85, 90% inefficiency of what we do when it's such great work and it's so helpful to people? So what can we do? And that's why I love working with KPMG and the alliance we have, because we know that with the customers you have, the experience you have, you understand the bottom of the iceberg. I am very pleased about the opportunities in front of us to be able to drive that inefficiency of the 85% of waste down to almost non-existent, because you get the training you need when you need it, based on data, as you mentioned, based on AI, based on inference, but also based on user input that gets it done. So I think the future is super bright, super optimistic about that. And I think CEOs who are concerned about the skills of their workforce are about to get a big assist, if you will, because we understand what the problem is and we're trying to help be part of the solution.
Excellent. Alessandro, I think you summed it up quite well. You know, yeah, very exciting time in the learning space, a big challenge ahead of us. But I think the convergence of that innovative technology and services and will deliver great results. And I'm looking forward to delivering those results as we go forward. Thank you so much.
For sure. Appreciate it. Thank you for having me.